Growing up, I had dreams and aspirations, but always felt like the kid that didn't fit in. For the most part, I wasn't a bad kid, but when I made the transition into adulthood, I turned to the streets for guidance. This led to getting locked up in juvenile hall, doing time in CYA, and eventually a 120-month sentence in federal prison. I had a lot of time to think and reflect during my federal sentence, so I share with you what I learned, hoping I can positively influence someone else's life with Prison Talk. What's up, everybody? Big Herc, Prison Talk. Thank you for tuning in and making us one of the most successful shows on YouTube. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. We're almost at 200,000 subscribers. When we hit 200K, we're going to be giving away a flat screen TV. So you don't want to miss out. You want to make sure you're subscribed so that you can automatically be entered to win the flat screen TV. If you haven't got a chance to check out our website, please do so at www.freshoutseries.com. We have a lot of cool stuff, and we finally got the shoes in. We're going to be doing pre-orders on those. They're dope. We got the slides in. You got your shower roll jumping off. Hey, man, get it in while you can. So make sure you guys check out the website. And also, if you got any questions, shoot us an email at freshoutseries@gmail.com. And check out our Twitter and our Instagram, which is FreshOutSeries, along with Patreon. Now, you know, I often get asked, like, what it took for me to actually make it and, you know, get to the point where I'm at now to be successful. And for a lot of people getting out of rehab or getting out of doing any type of time or significant amount of time, and you had a loss of like family or friends or just support in general, there's five steps I think that you could take that will help you overcome a lot of your obstacles and be successful. Now, a lot of these are contingent on your personality skills, how you're able to build relationships with other individuals, because people think have a tendency to think they could do things on their own. And really, in order to be successful, in society, you have to work with a group of people or a team. It takes more than one person to build a strong foundation when it comes to life. You know, doing it by yourself, you need somebody, whether you're selling something on internet, or you're working on a house, or, you know, you need resources. So for me, getting out, step one, okay, got out, went to the halfway house, didn't have a job, had a little bit of money. I had hustled somewhat in prison, so I had published my own book while I was in there. And so I had a little bit of resources, but not a whole lot. My family wasn't in LA, so I didn't have any, you know, family members here that I could actually go over and, you know, get food from or have visits or anything like that. So, but fortunately, I built up strong relationships in prison. A lot of good dudes, man. I fuck with a lot of good dudes. A lot of good dudes fuck with me. So, I had a friend that happened to be living in LA, not in the same area, but, another friend of mine who had, you know, been out in another city, he contacted that friend and let him know I was out, and basically reached out to that person. That person, you know, came and saw me when I was in the halfway house. He hooked me up with a job. So I got that job, and from that job, I was able to get passes to go work, to get out the halfway house, to start networking, to, you know, meet people, and actually get some income generated. So that was a big thing, having a job connection, step one. Step two, you know, halfway house, I had 3 months to basically get my shit together. And at that point, if you don't, you know, have a place to live, you're on the street. So you gotta have a place secured. Now, there's a number of ways you can do that. I mean, fortunately, I had another friend that I was cool with who hooked me up with a friend. So when I got out the halfway house, I was able to stay at their house. And by staying at their house, you know, basically rent free for 5 months, I was able to save up enough money to get my own, you know, eventually get my own place and get on my feet. But you got to have that grace period where you can save some kind of money, have a roof over your head, and be able to, you know, have something, have some type of financial foundation. So having a place to live is very important. Build relationships, man, whether it's pen pals, you know, you got a big girl, you know what I'm saying, you're working, or you got you know, a close friend, maybe he has a couch you can crash on and he'll let you say, hey, you live there, you know, till you can get on your feet. But wherever you go, make sure there's not going to be drugs. There's not going to be any drama, so you don't get caught up and catch a violation. Okay, step two. Step three, a car. A car is, you know, very, very vital as far as commerce, especially in LA, getting around. Everybody, public transportation is not big, so everybody uses a car. So what you want to do is either try to find somebody that'll let you use their car or somehow try to get funded for a used car. But a car is very important. But before you even have the car, you got to get your driver's license. So I forgot to mention that earlier, but that's one of the things I got while I was in the halfway house with a driver's license, social security card, got all that stuff situated so that I was able to get a car and be able to drive legitimately and have insurance and everything and registration. So that's very important, having a car, having your driver's license, having your social security card, because you can't get a job without producing valid ID nowadays. You can't just walk in there and work. They want to see everything, and they most likely want a photocopy. So that's number three. Number four is, you know, getting out on your own. Once you establish, you know, you're somewhat of a routine, you got money coming in, you can transition from the person's house you were living in to your own place, or most likely, or maybe renting a room from somebody, Craigslist, you know, Backpage, different places you can find rooms for rent, and, you know, basically be independent, you know, have your own, you know, private space for once. And in order to accomplish that, a lot of times I say renting a room's easier because they don't do a lot of credit checks. When you go to get an apartment, a lot of times people ask me and say, hey man, did you have to tell me you were a felon? No, I didn't. They knew nothing about that. All I did was put down my my employment, and to be honest with you, I think I actually, as far as where my residence was, I used like an old address as a previous address, and I had been gone almost 9 years, so it didn't make a big, you know, big deal. And my credit, because I was gone for so long, my credit was pretty much, you know, zero. It was nothing. I didn't really have a lot of any credit, but it was enough to get me in the apartment. And you know, that's how I did that. But getting a room is a lot easier because you don't have to worry about all the credit situations. You can kind of come in, get first and last month's rent, and just mind your business. Just make sure you lock your shit up, because if you got other people living in the house, they might steal your shit. Transitioning from your own room to your own place, like I said, that takes another step, you know, and that's going about doing, you know, getting your credit together, having secure employment that can be verified, you know, and you want to make sure that you have, you know, just certain things in order, because you're going to have to furnish your house. But, you know, those are the steps you need to take. And a lot of those I couldn't have done without having the right people around me, you know, whether it be friends I met in prison, you know, different hookups I came across on the street. But a lot of this I did without the support of my family. It's keeping it real. I did it by me out here hustling and getting on my feet. Because this is the thing, when you get out of rehab or out of the pen, a lot of people are kind of hesitant to even mess with you because they think, they don't know what kind of time you're on, and they think you're crazy. You know, you committed a bank robbery, you're motherfucking crazy. You ran up in there with a gun, you're crazy. You know, they want to see, you know, what, if they can even be around you, if, you know, if you're violent or if you're dangerous, or, you know, they'd have all these weird fantasies because of these damn Hollywood movies. So they don't know what time you're on. So the thing is, you have to convince a lot of people. Well, people who don't know, you don't have to convince, but family members and a lot of times friends, you know, before, they act funny until they see you on your feet, then they want to be cool with you. So you have to take those things in consideration. Getting out of rehab, same thing. You're on drugs, you've been stealing, doing this and that. People are reluctant to put a hand out, because they don't know if you're going to repeat the same cycle. You know, same thing with a guy, like I said, committing crimes, you know, the same cycle stuff. So you gotta, there's steps you can make, but those are the basic steps that I seen that was able to take me to the level I'm at now. And the thing is, if you don't have those, if I would have got out the halfway house and didn't have a place to live or didn't have any resources, you're going to be homeless. It's a sad reality, man. I hate to tell you, a lot of you guys, you're going to be homeless, man. You're going to be homeless. You're going to be talking to yourself. You're going to be on the street asking for stuff. You're going to be begging. It's going to be a bad situation. My co-defendant got out, you know, didn't make the proper connections while he was inside to get on his feet, didn't get his shit together, apparently, and was homeless living in L.A., Skid Row, man, got shot. You know what I mean? Died by the hands of police out there. So, you know, it's very important that you get your shit together. You build relationships. You be honest. You know, you be a you know, righteous dude, man. And people will, you know, bless you. You know, if you're on the right path, people could see that you got good energy. The things will fall in place, man. The hands will come out, and you'll be surprised what'll happen for you. But you need those things in order to make it. Otherwise, if you just think you're gonna get out here and run around, and you haven't built up any type of relationships, you're gonna fail. So be smart, make friends with different people, you know, don't burn people, you know. You'll never know who you're gonna run across later, somebody working somewhere and you might need them. Be smart, man, and just make the positive steps. But those are some of the things you can do to eventually get on your feet. And, you know, you gotta have that grace period. There's gotta be somebody out there willing to bless you so you can at least have a roof over your head while you try to gather your thoughts. And I was lucky to have that. I'm grateful to that person. And, you know, without that, I don't know where I would have been at. You know what I mean? I'd have been trying to, you know, I'd have been like swimming in the ocean like everybody else. And I've seen a lot of guys get out the halfway house and they came up short. So be smart, man.
Lockdown's over. Get your yard time in. Exclusively at FreshOutSeries.com.